A new power is rising and the victory is at hand. Today, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to play 1v7 in Battle for Middle-earth 1 on the patch 1.06 on the map Old Brownlands as Isengard against 7 Hard Mordors. Before further ado, let's get it started. Isengard will rule Middle-earth. At least I'm gonna try my best to win this game, and be aware because at the beginning of the game we are expecting to see many great Eye of Saurons on our base. 7 Mordors at the same time. I've never done this before, by the way. That's the first time. I believe it's gonna be kind of tough. Watch this now. I believe you're gonna see Eye of Sauron coming in clutch very soon. PowerPoint-wise, you see that? Multiple eyes, boys. 4 of them at the same time. They are scouting. They are curious, you know, what we are doing. The Uruk-hai will rise from the Uruk pit. Indeed, and remember what Gimli was saying, this is no rubble of mindless orcs. These are Uruk-hai. Their armor is thick and their shields broad. And hopefully their shields are broad enough, because we will have to kill so many units with only 160 available command points. It's gonna be quite tough. Especially early game, it's gonna be kinda tough because I believe they will spam lots of orcs on us all the time. Look at the eye. It's so bright, I can't even see anything, dude. Luckily, Uruks are fast enough, we need to capture. And the downside of Isengard faction, in compared to all the other factions like Mordor, Rohan and Gondor, is that we have no Gollum, no Pippin and no Merry, which means we cannot get a hero on the field early on, and we will have to build the Uruk pit to be able to capture those settlements, you know? That's the problemo. You know what? Let's put pressure, guys. Pressure. We can bring the fight to them. Oh, but he's getting attacked. That's fine. We need to also get lords on the field as soon as possible. Remember, Isengard has only 2 available factions. Let's put pressure on this guy. Maybe we can actually hurt his economy a bit by using the war chant on the Uruks. Get inside the genes. And also, this lumber mill is going, you know, going to give us the wood bonus, which means cheaper buildings inside our base. Now, we have 3 of them, which means 20% discount. 280 instead of 350, so pretty nice. 70 cheap, you know, 70 cheaper. Amazing. We have double Haradrim Palace for the 1 Mordor, but he will be losing all the resource buildings, and that's gonna... I mean, that doesn't really matter anything, I believe, because, you know, the evil factions, they have so much money. They don't start like us with 1,000 resources, they start like with 5,000, you know what I'm saying? And also keep in mind that orcs are for free, so he doesn't need money to be able to get units on the field. Maybe we can actually take down this one as well, would be awesome. But now is the time for saving up to lords. Now let's, if we can destroy this mill, it would be actually amazing. But we gotta kill the archers first, boys. Archers are very weak against Uruks in a melee fight. And also from killing archers, you will get so much experience points that we can hit level 2 in no time. Okay, we have enough money for lords. Cash floating is bad. Don't cash float ever in any of the RTS games you are playing. By the way, I'm also looking forward for the Age of Empires 4 release. It's gonna happen, I believe, in the next couple of days. And I will be streaming that on my Twitch channel the second they release that. And also on our Twitch channel, we're gonna give a huge giveaway of 2 Age of Empires 4 in the Digital Deluxe Edition. So if you wanna have a chance of winning one of the games, make sure to follow us on Twitch. The link is in the description down below. And get a chance of winning one of the amazing upcoming games, which normally costs 80 bucks, by the way, the Digital Deluxe Edition, and you have the chance to get it for free. Let's build 2 more towers. Let's build full towers because I see them moving from the bottom right side. It's gonna be creeping this one first and moving on right after. And also building before we lose the mills means we can get the chance to build them a bit cheaper. So we need to combine the Uruks with the Crossbowmen. The reason is simple. We lose damage, yes, but we have some tanky units in the front line. And also, let's use war chant on them and put some pressure. We can put lords also close to him, close to the crossbowman unit. This way we can share experience and get lords to level 5 a little bit faster this way. And there comes the army. They are attacking over here and more of them are coming. Holy guacamole. Hey, shoot please, crossbowman. Okay, I think we're not gonna combine them. We need to use them as like a shield unit to make sure that our Uruk pit is not gonna be taken down, because if the Uruk pit goes down, that's gonna be the worst case scenario for us. Maybe it was not the best idea to build the Uruk pit in the front, but I didn't want to walk all the way up from the bottom to the top side to be able to capture those mills. Oh man, what is this pressure? We lost the Uruk pit in no time. We have 2 power points collected. We have enough for the industry, but we have not any units besides the 1 crossbowman. And Lourdes, that's it. And we're also losing the towers left and right. That's a big problemo. Actually, let's cancel this and build the Uruk pit there instead. Let's throw the Sword Lords and use Carnage. Try to buy some time until the Furnaces are hitting level 3. When they are level 3, it's going to be much, much easier for us because they're going to be extremely tanky. And also, they're going to act like a tower. I see you. Yeah. Oh my goodness. Kill, 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 kill. Kill before they kill the Citadel. Kill before they kill the Citadel. The archers, they are not dealing too much damage to the buildings, but orcs are dealing surprisingly lots of damage to our buildings. We need more crossbowmen, guys. Lourdes has to be level 5 as soon as possible. Let's kill this unit. Once the orcs are gunners, the archers, they have no... They are no threat, you know, because they don't deal damage to the buildings, like mentioned many, many times. Looks like we are in a kind of safe spot. But this is going down for sure. Crossbowmen, be careful. We can maybe try to save them and buy banner on them later on to replace the dead ones, you know, from the battalion. We also need to get Freezing Rain. Look at that. Columns are coming. More units are coming all the time. Lourdes, shoot, 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 Lourdes. Do your thing, my dude. Furnaces, please hit level 3. But not even close. It's going to still take some time. Watching you. Let's use also the Wedge Formation to increase the DPS, to kill the enemy units a bit faster. Let's wait for the second Crossbowman and use War Chant right after. Hey, Lourdes, don't get into the melee range, I'm telling you. Okay, let's get now many, many Berserkers on the field. Go, 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 Crossbowman. Go fast, 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 fast. Let's use War Chant. Just like that. Lourdes, hopefully he's gonna get level 5 very soon. Let's defend this area. We are losing the towers left and right. We gotta make sure that we are saving our citadel, though. That's the most important building right now. After the Uruk pit, of course. Uruk pit is even more important than that. More berserkers are needed, guys. Look at the pressure. 5, okay. That means leadership is unlocked. We have more DPS now, which is amazing and also needed. You know what? We can actually get a potential... Let's get Freezing Rain first. I have an idea. Let's get Freezing Rain. Let's use it. Even though they have no leadership right now. Alright. Crossbowman, do a good job. Nice. Level 3 furnace now. That's huge. That's huge, guys. That's huge. Okay, now replace the towers. We are losing. And now we can get Saruman on the field. That's gonna buy us some time, hopefully. And once again, once the furnace are level 3, just like this one, for example, that's gonna be a bit easier for us. We keep losing this stuff all the time. Lourdes, stay closer to the crossbowman. To make them deal 60% more damage. 3 power points collected, that's great. Now we're gonna go for the Tainted Land. I see Eye of Sauron, but remember, Freezing Rain is still active. That means Mordor has still no leadership. Replace the buildings and also the towers. Very important. Oh, he has catapults already, my dude. I don't even see anything because the eye. He has catapults already, yes. Now that doesn't look very good for us, boys. Let's kill this catapult as soon as possible. Let's peel back with the level 2. Lourdes, go inside the jeans, use Carnage, and take down the catapult. I don't see anything. I don't see anything. What's going on? Lourdes, be careful. Don't die. Don't die. Let's kill this mill. Saruman, can you please... What is the spell, boys? What is the spell? Let's use the industry once again. Let's use it right here. Demolish the one which is only level... Oh, we missed the industry too, but it's okay. It's not the end of the world. Oh, here's Nazgul already. Nazguls and Lourdes is going down. Holy guacamole. We gotta kill those Nazguls ASAP. Let's demolish the furnace and build. Let's revive Lourdes first of all. Okay, they are dying though, luckily for us. And more catapults are coming. Dude, that's crazy actually how difficult this is. Victory is at hand. Are you sure about that, bro? Okay, they are going down to our towers. We need devastation as soon as possible. We also need to use the fireball on this catapult, guys. All right, that's good. That's gonna buy us some time. Let's use also the Worm Tongue. Steal and fight for us. Nice. Peel back. The thing is, when you use Worm Tongue with Saruman, he's not gonna be able to move for multiple seconds. Just buy us some time. Let's get more units on the field in the meantime. But wait a second. We need to get devastation. We can't even get Devastation unlocked yet, yeah? Oh, man. We need a bit more than that. But we should be getting the power points unlocked soonish because we are killing so much right now. Alright, so let's use Devastation to be able to get the upgrades from the armory. Don't lose level 2. Get back. He has even fire purchased already. Let's go with a blast them. Level 3 furnaces are doing a phenomenal job. We also need that. We desperately, desperately need that. Oh, there comes the Nazgul. Let's kill the Nazgul, please. Fireball him. Nice. Fireball deals a lot of damage. Replace the towers. We are losing all the time. And the Nazgul is gonna fall into darkness. Oh, man. We gotta wait for the Lurts, boys. We gotta wait for the Lurts. Let's combine them with the Crossbowman level 2. Give them also fire. And also, this Nazgul is there now. Kill him if you can. Lurts is also on the field. That's beautiful. Holy guacamole, guys. Holy guacamole. We have not many units, but, you know, from the Crossbowman, they also died. All of them, actually. Saruman, please do... Oh my goodness, Saruman, you need to kill this catapult. There is another catapult. Lurts, throw your sword and kill this catapult. You peel back combos. Get more Crossbowman. Get also the heavy armor purchased. Fireball him. Let's use Carnage for more DPS and also tankiness. Dude, why is this Saruman attacking so slowly? Oh, another one. Just like that. Okay. Alright, peel back, peel back. Saruman, handle... Oh, we don't need to. Okay, we don't need to. Just peel back with the level 2 combo. Because we need to give him some time to recover. And keep replacing. Lurts, please don't die again. I cannot afford to lose you. You are level 6. You are very valuable because you have now the pillage, which means we get money for killing enemy units. Let's use Freezing Rain one more time. Oh, again. Catapults for these. Flashback from the Mordor one. Okay, Fireball was able to handle this for now. But long story short, we will need faster units. We will need more combos. A new power is rising. Yeah, yeah, we hurt you, man. You are just like the Witch King now, who was just spamming No Man Can Kill Me, and yet he ended up dying many, many times. We gotta give time to Lurts also to recover. It's too dangerous now to move out with him yet. We also need blades, and then we can demolish this right after. Now we need to save for the Balrog as soon as possible. We have no mills, that's why it's kind of pointless to get the Fuel the Fires upgrade from the spellbook, which only is valuable when you have many, many mills outside under your control. It's level 1, let's make him level 2, which is increasing the DPS. More units. Saruman, you don't move. Looks like we have some time to breathe. Okay. Where is the other Uruk now? If we lose the Uruk again? Not sure. Alright, did we purchase all the upgrades? Yes, that means we can now demolish. Oh my goodness, what is this? Kill the Nazgul first. Saruman, you fireball the... Not the Nazgul. No, not the Nazgul. Actually, we don't need to fireball anything right now. We gotta kill this Ram, though. The Ram is actually hitting like a truck against our buildings. Holy moly. Also being so tanky at the same time. Combine. Alright, so let's get them all the upgrades. Now we can group with Lurts. Let's fireball this. I don't see anything because of the Eye of Saurons, you know? I don't see anything, literally. Alright, let's move on. Lurts can join the party. And more Nazguls are coming all the time. But luckily, they are actually trying to destroy our buildings and not our units. But with Lurts' leadership and also especially War Chants later on from the spellbook, we should be able to one-shot these Nazguls in no time. What? Why did we get a pikeman now? That's kind of confusing. Didn't want to do that, actually. Let me tell you that much. Oh, luckily... Oh my goodness, look how many catapults does he have. Let's use War Chants here. Don't kill. Move. Micro. Move around. And more catapults are coming also from this side. Catapult spammer. Oh, don't shoot. Okay, you win. Fireball, okay. You kill this. Zaplast, maybe? I don't know. You gotta kill this catapult, though, as soon as possible. We need to ignore everything else, boys. And also kill these rams, man. Okay, we killed him. Nice, beautiful. Oof, that's so tough. We are command points capped too. Oh, that's even worse. We can't recruit any more units right now. Holy guacamole, man. Let's actually sacrifice the pikemen because they are kind of not good for anything. But we can try to deal some economical damage at least. Not that it really matters because, once again, evil factions, they are so rich, they don't need money. Alright, let's go group like this. Go back with the one who's damaged. Move around a little bit. Fight and try to dodge the catapult shots. We have also industry available. We need at least 5,000 to be able to buy the base after destroying it. Spear. Let's use devastation to get a bit more money. And more crossbowmen are needed. I don't see anything from the Eye of Saurons. I don't see anything, bro. More catapult. Let's fireball this one. And kill this one. Don't shoot me. We have command points limited once again. Hey, Saruman, Saruman, don't. Alright, let's be back. Let's be back for now. We are only 5 power points away from getting the Balrog summon unlocked, which we can use after using the vision of Palantir to get the vision we need. We gotta peel back with the Saruman for a bit because he's badly damaged, and losing him is a no-go right now, as we have not enough money to replace him and buy the castle after destroying that. And also I have bad news for you guys, because Balrog is only able to one-shot the Gondor and Rohan castle, but not the Mordor castle. So Balrog all alone is not going to be enough to actually crush the enemy base all alone. That's not possible. That's why we need to reinforce them with this combinations of Uruks and Crossbowmen, as well as Lurds. Very important. And for that reason, let's make a second army. Saruman, you can stay in the base, chill a bit. You are the wizard at the end of the day. And let's put some counter pressure on the guy at the bottom right side. Try to fish the power points we need. Saruman, you can fireball maybe. Would be amazing if you could. Oh, Witch King, no problemo. Should be able to kill him in no time. Alright, kill this catapult. Move. Okay, nice. Did we kill this catapult too? Yes, we did. Now we can peel back with the wizard once again. Alright, more Nazguls, of course. More catapults. We gotta kill the katas first, before anything else. Oh my goodness, we are taking so much damage, guys. Holy moly. A new power is rising. We already hurt you many, many times. If you can... Lords, why are you moving away? Didn't tell you to move away yet. Can we kill the Siege Wars, please? Move! Okay, maybe not. I don't know. Let's commit on it. Okay, we killed it. That's huge. Alright, in the meantime, what's happening? I see eyes once again. So, you guys disengage for now. And Lords, you can be grouped with these guys. Look, 3 golems are on the hand. They are chasing our Lords. Okay. And yeah, we have now one more crossbowman. It's amazing. That's what I thought. Told you guys. This way we can extend our command points. Crossbowman behind. What is the pressure, dude? What is this pressure? Saruman. Okay, so basically what we need to do now is we need to unlock the Balrog. Use the vision of Palantir to summon Balrog. Kill these units first. Saruman, you join. Now fly inside the genes. With the ignite on. Kill this citadel first, please, Balrog. And yeah. Oh, what is this? Oh my goodness. He's going inside the base. Oh, that was a horrible breath fire. We gotta kill these catapults, boys. Come to me, my creatures. You'll do what I say. We gotta kill these catapults. You wanna fight, Felvis? I don't know if this is a good thing, good idea from you. Oh, we couldn't. Okay, just... Oh, Lurch is dead. I don't know, it's for me hard because I need to focus on so many things at the same time. We gotta revive Lurch. In the meantime, we are also getting attacked from more catapults and stuff like that. Can we breath fire one more time? Would be awesome if we can. Looks like we won't be able to finish him off this time, boys. We gotta peel back, though. I don't want to lose all the combos once again. So, yeah, we have lost a lot. We have lost Lurds. We have lost one of the full combination of the units. Oh, no, no, no! Oh, I thought this is like an enemy. When you right click on a slaughterhouse, you will send or sell your units to it, you know? Don't do that, ever. We are command points kept all the time, my dude. All the time. Actually, you know what? I would like to finish this guy off as soon as possible now. So for that reason, let's move on. Number one, number two. We need to finish him off, guys. This guy has to be finished. Because we need to make something happen. Defending all alone is not gonna win us the game. They will just get more and more catapults on the field. Fireball him. Fireball him. Okay, which king is going down? No man can kill you, but a wizard for sure can. Okay, no more catapults coming for now. So I see so much ice and stuff like that. It's hard for me to see what's going on. Let's just kill the buildings first, please. Saruman needs to stay a bit closer for the armor leadership, but of course the most important one is Lord, and he's almost back up on the field. With a blast, there we go, nice. We have still the thing on cooldown. Let's use speechcraft to give them some experience. Okay, let's kill the citadel. What is happening in the meantime here? I see no catapults yet, so we should be fine. Let's use war chant, make them a bit stronger. Send this one back, because he's actually this one also back. Because they are taking so much damage, this combo can keep fighting. Let's fight for me. I'm gonna steal them. Hopefully they're gonna make some work for me. Just kill the buildings. Just kill the buildings. That's all you gotta do. Kill the orc pit. And the last remaining slaughterhouse, please. That's all I'm asking you for. And that's gonna finish this base. Let's use fireball to speed up the progress a bit. And we will be able to extend our command points once again. Okay, this army has been defeated. That's huge. That's huge, by the way. We have 6 power points collected, which means we have now everything unlocked from the spellbook of Isengard. But we have not a single minute time to actually recover, because we are getting attacked all the time. But now we can make sure that we are not getting attacked from the right side anymore. Now we need to target the bottom right opponent, you know? So furnaces for this. And also towers around. Luckily, we have now a bit better resource income. Come to me, my servants. Alright, so basically, now we gotta make a new army with Lurtz, who is going to join Saruman. Join Saruman. Is there a catapult coming? No, no catapult. No catapult, no problemo. Here also no catapults yet. So that's the army. That's beautiful. I see also units from the bottom side, but it's fine. Now we have towers up. Wait, let's buy this one. Okay, so now let's group with this unit. And Saruman can also join the party to support them with additional damage, not damage, armor and combat experience leadership. We have work to do. And you do what I say, lords. A new power is rising. Balrog is almost back up. But let's try to defeat this guy without using the Balrog summon. Would be awesome. Can we use speechcraft again? It's almost up, so we always use it. There is no reason to not use it, of course. Okay. I do what you say. Let's group them all together. Let's use. Get them experience. What is happening in the meantime? Are we getting attacked from catapults? I can't see anything, so I don't think so. Alright, so let's group them all together for a big war chant. Oh. Nazgul, you're gonna die. Witch King, you're gonna die too. Everything is getting blown up. Do you see that, guys? That's a burst. Hey, hey, hey. Don't die. Level 4 would be a shame if we lose him. Just run for your life. After defeating the second one, you will also get the chance to have more command points available. Heal back a little bit. Don't tank anything. Just deal as much damage as we potentially can. Saruman can try to kill the units in the meantime. However, he's a wizard at the end of the day, so he's a caster. Don't tank with this crossbowman. That's why you combine them, by the way, because the combined units, they have Uruks in the front line, and the Uruks are just tankier, much tankier. Saruman is tanking the damage, but it's fine. I want to just focus on the buildings for now. Oh, here's the call the horde. Embrace my power. Okay. Let's send also this unit back. And also Saruman can maybe go back. Even though it's kind of bad because I would like to keep him. Since he's giving also a decent amount of armor leadership. I don't think we can finish him off right now. Might be wrong though. Lords, why are you not nearby? Lords need to stay a bit closer. Okay, now we have units recovering here. That's beautiful. Kill the buildings only. Let's steal the enemy units. Fight for me. Beautiful. Fireball is almost back up. Just focus down the buildings. That's all you gotta do. We have also... Why is this unit not recovering though? He's not being there forever. Kinda bad. Hopefully it's not bugged or something. Just focus down the buildings, yeah. Okay, beautiful. Alright, nice, great. Now we have also defeated the second one without using the Balrog. Amazing. And like mentioned before, now we've also access to more power points. Or, you know, command points, rather. I believe this unit is back, so we can send him now back to the slaughterhouse to make some space. For more units. We also need to be patient with this one, because the one in the front side is a bit damaged. Give him the chance to fully recover. I have a surprise for you guys for the last standing faction. After we defeat a couple of more, the last one is gonna be a surprise. I will show you guys something quite funny. You will like to see that, trust me. Hey. What is this Nazgul army? But you see crossbowmen are hitting like a truck, guys, with war chant, and when they are hiding out like that. Oh my goodness. Catapult, go back to the shadow. Okay, beautiful. So, oh, what is up? Oh my goodness, man. We need maybe melee units, I don't know. Just kill back. Move on. Kill. Move. Every time they shoot, we need to move. Move now again. You see, to dodge the incoming damage. We still got hit, but not many times anymore. He's killing all our towers, and every furnace is still level only 2 or 1. That's why. But did you guys know that when you are using industry on your furnaces, that they are also able to level up a bit faster this way? Okay, let's make more units in the meantime. Let's use... No, that we don't need to use Speechcraft because they're already level 10. More catapults are coming. That's why we gotta make a move. Let's call on the Balrog summon. But we need to also empower this once again to make him... to make sure that we are able to finish off this base. If we lose all the crossbowmen... Oh yeah, it feels like that. Attack. Why are you cancelling your auto-attack? Please! Hey, Lord Saruman! Oh my goodness, it was the worst Balrog summon I've ever seen in my life. And I would never thought that it's gonna be me. Ooh, yeah, breath on your face, son. What is happening in the meantime? I see no more catapults, so the furnace are hitting level 3 slowly but surely. Lie on top of the siege works. Kill it.
We have work to do.
We have work to do. Is there a catapult coming out? I can whip this one though. Phew. Nice. So just defeat this. A new power is rising. Nice. We defeated the Heart Army. Beautiful. And we have also level 10 combos now. It's even better. We have also more units coming from this base. And we are now going to be able to also capture this castle now. Amazing. Beautiful, guys. We are doing a phenomenal job. I thought it's going to be almost impossible, though. The first couple of minutes into the game, holy moly, was quite rough. But that's the power of the White Wizard Saruman. Let's build 2 Uruk pits now. I mean, I am not scared of the Witch King or something because we have level 10 combos with Lord's leadership. There is no chance. They can't do anything about that. Look, this Nazgul now. You wanna fight?
Come to me, my creature.
The White Hand will not
fight. Watch this Nazgul. When they shoot a couple of times, he's gonna get bursted down in a second. What is happening in the meantime? Here we are in a safe spot. You know what we can do? We can also make a move maybe from this side. And yeah, just get more units on the field all the time. Just move on. I don't want to lose too many units though. We need to make sure that we are able to save the level 10 combos. Very important. Just move out. Oh, but I don't mind about losing them, to be honest. As long as we can kill at least... Okay, never mind. Just go back. Just kill the catapults and go back. Kill this. And then siege forks. When you kill the siege forks, I don't mind about anything else, to be honest. Is someone shooting us down or something? I think it does. I think there is a catapult or something. Let's use the Palantir. No. Okay, let's be back. This army can't get any bigger. Okay. Many Nazguls and the Witch King, of course. But yeah, let's go anyway, I guess. Let's go anyway. You do what I say. We get also so much money and value from the scavenge. I mean, Lourdes, guys, let me know what you think about Lourdes in the comment section down below. Lourdes has to be the best hero of the game, right? Cost efficient wise, of course. He's just giving you everything what you're asking for. He gives you everything that you need. Gives you leadership, damage. I don't need to use fireball here. He's gonna die anyway. Didn't be wasting that one. Okay. Hey, hey, hey. Oh, fine hit from him, actually. Saruman, don't take too much damage. Hey, combos, would you please contribute also to the fight? Would be awesome if you would. We don't need to use War Chant yet. Let's go for an attack. I want to actually lose this army because I want to make a brand new one. Okay, join this army. Uruks with upgrades and we can use them for dealing damage to the buildings. You know what I'm saying? He was also rebuying the siege warriors. What a meme. Let's kill this. And then kill this siege warriors right after. Wait for the Uruks. And now we're gonna use War Chant. There we go. And go inside the jeans with Uruks. Let's see how much damage we will be able to deal with the one single Urukai without leadership. But only from the War Chant. But they have forge blades and heavy armor. I wanna show you guys the power of Uruks. One single Urukai, by the way. Watch this. They're bursting down everything in seconds. Okay, guys, peel back. Can we save them? Yeah, we can. Nice. This way we can always extend our command points. You know, that's very important. We attack soon. Look how tanky they are. What are you waiting for? Hey, Saruman, you need to join the party too? Industry? Money is looking good. But, you know, like mentioned a couple of times, this way we can... and get the furnaces to level 3 a bit sooner, which is going to increase the durability of our base significantly. Banner carrier. Okay, so we have more Uruks coming. That's beautiful. Go inside the jeans with Uruks. Don't lose the level 10 combo. Very important to keep him safe and alive. Saruman is almost level 10 too, but it doesn't really matter because Saruman has no level 10 ability in battle for Middle Earth 1. Okay, so after defeating this one, we're gonna move on to the top right. In 10, we have only the two factions left, the top left and the middle one. But of course, we need to first of all defeat this dude, and then the other dude. Kill this so he can't rebuy anything. Warchan is almost back up. Saruman, he can go for a Visaplas maybe. Okay, nice. Kill the buildings, only beautiful Visaplas from our young Saruman. Where are the Uruks, by the way? We need you guys. Move on, Urukai. And also, we can use Palantir on them. But I want to use actually Palantir to see what this guy is doing. Oh, he's ready. He's ready. You know what? I'm also ready. Let's call the Balrog. This guy thinks he can spam me with catapults and get away with that? Hell no, brother. Hell no. Okay, your katas are gone. Please attack. Don't sleep. Breath fire from the demons of the ancient world. Nice. We killed the siege wargs. Fly. Oh, Witch King. Oh, look, Witch King, guys. Phew. It's a fly. You know. There's no chance. Oh, you don't one-shot that? Really? Well, 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 that's unfortunate then. Oh, actually, when I think we can do it. I think we can actually defeat the entire base of evil with Balrog all alone. I messed up, but it's definitely possible. Let me tell you that much. It's definitely, definitely possible. Balrog is kind of busted in battle for Middle Earth 1, dude. That's crazy how effective this dude actually is. Hey, hey, hey. Oh my goodness, here they come. Look how many Nazguls. Are you kidding me? Kill the Nazguls. Kill the Witch King. I don't know what's going on. Build towers. More towers. Why take so much time to kill them? Kill them already. We have not many archers, probably. This is the problem, you know? Lords, attack this Witch King, please. Build more towers. Full tower beast, by the way. Just why not? Holy moly. We have not many archers, guys. That's the biggest problem. You know what? We can try to finish off this dude with the Uruks instead. Let's go. And let's use also the Palantir on the Uruks to make them a bit faster. Because Palantir is also giving us 15% more increased movement speed. We are in a safe spot for now. That's good. Let's replace the towers. And just wait until they are able to recover. But in the meantime, holy moly. Okay, I see you. Dude, an army of catapults, guys. Just why not? You gotta kill those catapults ASAP. War chant is on cooldown. So we need to hope that this is gonna be enough to defeat them. Should be enough. Let's kill this one first. The Citadel, use the shield wall formation to make them a bit tankier. And try to not lose the space. Try to not lose the space. For that reason, we gotta kill the catapults. We lost all the crossbowmen, right? Yeah. The enemy is in our camp. Okay, nice. We killed. That's important and beautiful. Let's replace that. And now we have also, of course... What happened to the Uruks? Like, Uruks, please move on. Okay, guys, we need to support them now with our army, main army. I'm actually pretty tempted to do something different now. I'm gonna do that, guys. Let's go. Hold on. More berserkers are coming, that's good. We gotta kill those catapults. That's very important. Keep moving on, please, army. And also, this is under attack. Holy moly. Uruks, we need you. Fight for me. Lost the Citadel, right? Yeah, we did lose the Citadel, actually. Oh, man. Alright, just go inside the base and finish off the buildings, please. Lords, you also support them actively. Use your sword, carnage and everything, and go inside the genes. Kill the buildings only. Uruks, please, can you kill this catapult before they destroy entire base? Look. A new power is rising. I have all. Nice, we defeated him. Nice, beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Oh man, in the meantime, also this base is going down, actually. Oh man, the catapult spam, you know? I have nightmares of that. Also, last time against Gondor, in which he was spamming trebuchets all game long, was also not fun to deal with. And look at that. He keeps pressuring me all the time with his catapults. And the problem is our arrows, our towers, and also furnaces are not able to damage those catapults at all. Oh, man. But now we have 300 command points available. That's dope. Nice. So basically, let's buy this. And now move again to the second camp. With Saruman and also Lurtz. And level 10 combos. Let's build furnaces only. And now we are getting closer to the initial plan I was talking about, guys, earlier. You will like that, trust me. We need to defeat only one more dude, though, before that. And I believe this army should be enough to handle the situation. We will see about that. So let's build only siege warriors. Let's build 5 of them. Okay. 5 siege warriors to rule them all. Oh, man, but the pressure here is also real. Okay, let's replace the... No, we can't even replace because the city is still not up on the field. Oh, there comes the army of Nazgûl. Or only one single Nazgûl, though. That's nothing, okay. Please kill the catapult. That's all I'm asking you for. You guys kill the... Just kill the cutter. That's all you gotta do. Don't lose level 3 furnace. Oh, it's late. Okay. It is how it is. Let's kill this. Okay. And I think that's gonna be our next target. And for the last one, we're gonna have a surprise. We need to kill this because he spams catapults all the time on us. Use ignite as you are flying. This way you will be ignited the second you land. Alt attack, please. Okay, nice. Right, guys, you guys move. Breath fire, beautiful. We killed a lot. Two attacks are needed to kill the citadel. Now we gotta fly. Okay. We need to get all these siege forks level 2. Kill. But he cancels out attacks all the time for whatever reason. Let's fly. Ignite once again. Breath fire. I don't know if this is gonna be enough to kill this beast, but we will see about that. Yeah. Almost killed with Balrog all alone, but in the meantime, we are also under attack. Would be a shame if we lose this. Saruman, please go in. And let's try to finish off this beast, shall we? Okay, we are getting ballistas now. That's a dream. Crossbowman, beautiful. Move on. Kill. Alright, beautiful. And I believe defeating this will also defeat this. We will see though. I think it's gonna happen. Or? Yeah, okay, perfect. We can handle this couple of crossbowmen, no problemo. So the siege works is about to hit level 2. And because it's now a 1v1 situation, we have also more command points. We have up to 400 command points, which is always the case in a one-on-one situation. In BFME1, when you are playing evil factions like Isengard or Mordor. Alright, so let's use the ballistas to pressure this side. Okay. And also here we gotta build siege warriors. A new power is rising. Let's build full siege warriors to show them the new power. Now you know how it's gonna feel like very soon, guys. It's not cool when you spam all the time. Come, my servants. Look how many ballistas we have. Oh yeah, look at these guys now, please. I have an idea. I'm gonna show you guys a grand finals of this video. And please make sure, guys, to like the video. Likes are helping quite a lot. And if you want to see more BFME content in the future, make sure to be subscribed to the channel as well. It would be awesome. I would really appreciate you guys if you would do me the favor. Hey! Turn and fight. Boom! On your face, son. There we go. Nice. Saruman, peel back. First of all, we gotta get those to level 2. Every single one of them. That's why we need always a double ballista. The bomb is ready. Okay, finally, we are safe. Let's use industry here. Replace the towers just to feel a bit more safe. And you can see yourself that the Isengard base has such a crazy durability, you know? Huge, huge ballista army. Hey, Lords. Who's War Chant? Let's use Palantir. Lords is in a safe spot. I'm not worried about Lords. Alright, just kill the Citadel. That's all you gotta do. And just pressure, pressure, pressure. Look how many Haradrim. Yes, 1, 2, 3 Haradrim Palace, 2 Orcpits. Oh well, that's not gonna. He's not gonna like what I'm gonna do with him very soon, guys. Trust me. He has nothing to actually make those explosive mines explode either. Oh yeah. Oh, that's gonna be fun. That's gonna be quite fun. More are needed. More are needed. More explosive mines. More explosive mines. More explosive mines. More. 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 Okay, and send the ballistas forward. Look how long it takes for him to destroy the ballistas, though. And that's how it's a proof that siege works in BFME1 is kind of tough and annoying at the same time to deal with. You know what I'm saying? Very annoying. Balrog is not needed. And I can also show you a magic trick with Balrog, guys, if you guys want to see that. Let me actually show you guys the magic trick with Balrog first. So basically, did you guys know that you can actually kind of 100-0 a Balrog with 3 explosive mines only? And I will show you guys what I'm talking about. So let's put them here next to each other. Don't put these next to each other because we need them later on. But watch now. We're gonna summon Balrog. Why can I not summon Balrog? I don't get it. Let's detonate them. It's not gonna work out, right? But watch. Yeah, almost one-shotted, as you can see. Almost 100-0'd. Yeah. Power, boys. Power of... Oh, wait. I don't wanna defeat him, though. With the ballistas. That's not what I want to happen. Just stands around. Okay, so let's go now, guys. Go now. I think we have enough explosive mines to go ham inside the jeans. Okay, let's go. So basically now we're gonna run it down into his piece. We're gonna place all the mine shafts, all the explosive mines around his entire castle. And then we will be using, of course, to end this game, the fireball from our Wizard Sauron. Okay, that's the plan. To make it boom boom. So the base of Mordor is, you know, going into the darkness. And we prove that the real Maia, the real ruler of Middle-earth, is actually the White Wizard Saruman and not Sauron. And we can also connect them. When you put them next to each other, they can be connected. That means you need to only use one fireball and that's it. Look at that. Holy moly. Saruman, you need to feel and wait a little bit, man, before anything else. All right. Quickly, set it down. Keep the fire away. Keep the fire away. That's so funny. Set it up. Prime it. Keep the fire away. Keep the fire away. Watch now. Watch the fiesta. It's gonna be clown fiesta now, boys. I hope it's gonna be enough to kill the bees. It would be kind of awkward if we can't. This army can't go any bigger. Get a hold of it. Don't you drop it. Alright. Let's try. Hopefully it's gonna work out. Maybe we need more mines, though. I wanna make sure that it's working, though. Just get them inside. Please, the mine. When they are placed like that, they don't even kill it, by the way. I don't know why. It's hard to focus them, I guess, when they're placed like that. I think we are still missing like two-ish. Yeah, I think we need at least two more. But it's okay, we are getting more now. I think we need one here or one here. And then we need one here. One here, potentially. Ah, it should be fine, I guess. Okay, I think now it should be fine. Okay, guys, ladies and gentlemen, for the final move of this video, which was kind of painful, and I hope you're okay with me trying to take my revenge here by giving them what they give me all the time, the suffer game, and I will be using the explosive mines from Isengard in the fireball from our wizard Saruman, okay? Watch this, ladies and gentlemen, watch this. Boom, 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 boom. Oh, that was satisfying. I like it. And we are victorious just like that. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Don't forget to leave a like. Subscribe if you haven't already. I will see you next time. Until then, take care of yourself. Keep hitting like a truck. And as always, stay beyond standards. Peace out.